Howdy my friends, welcome back to more or less play Gran Turismo 3. This is Sky Hurricane, and this part we're gonna do our final endurance race, the Mistral 78 laps. So let's see, what car do I want to use? Let's go by value again, because we're gonna need to use a pretty competitive car. I'd like to use something I haven't shown in this project yet, the Astra. Could use it. 54 horsepower. I wonder how good the... I was actually planning on using this FTO, which obviously I'd take the turbo kit off. Haven't used this all kits either. Except off screen, when I redid an all tits of championship. Let's choose this little underpowered Astra. I mean, why the heck not? Actually, it's a V8 in this little thing. Alright, so we'll do our usual, get our tires. I wonder how much this will tune up. No turbo kit. Oh, 790. That's pretty powerful. Alright, let's do this. Final endurance race, my friends. Are you ready? Mistral 78 laps. Oh, and I forgot to say this. Earned the title of Tokyo's fastest. I forgot to read that last time. Really nothing. Doesn't really say much on this. Coded this year. And 500,000 for this race. Can we even win it with this Astra? I don't know. This car really doesn't fit in. The FTO probably would have fit in a little better. Because I don't think you ever see any of the German touring cars in this. We're actually versing an FTO and an R39 to Eljoy. We'll see how this goes. So, their usual. Yeah, we definitely have the least power out of any of those. I'll minimize this. And you know what? I'm going to lower this a little bit. I think we're ready. Alright, here we go. Opel service. I'm probably going to drive with this view in this track because, oh my gosh, this track. I'm not too severely underpowered. Matter of fact, I'm kind of keeping up with the Jaguar. High FTO, high of GT40, who's kind of sucking, and then my Esperanto's in my way. Yeah, sheer power is really not going to do you too many favors in this race. Do you too many favors, because other factors will do you more of a favor. Kind of interested to see how this race is going to turn out. So far the R390 is definitely beating me. Pretty good, too, I might add. But we know how the computers suck on this, so I'm not giving up hope yet. I did absolutely no testing on this, so I don't know how hard this is going to be. My tires are still cold, so I got to be careful. Well, we're killing everybody else. I think the only one we're going to have to worry about is this R390. Come on, little Astra. This is a cute little car. So How long will this race be? I'm figuring probably 2 hours. So we're staying around 3.5 seconds behind. At least that's what we were midway through the last lap. I lose a lot of time through here, though. This car is very spin happy in third gear, or second gear. And that's causing me to lose a lot of time. Oh gosh, he's killing me. I just want to stay in third gear for some of those corners. Staying third through there didn't really hurt too much. Yeah, we're just going to try next lap. Not going below third gear. Well, we didn't lose too much time. Come on, Astra. Golly, I wonder who broke away. No idea. Esperante, maybe? I figured the FTO would have to be the worst out of the bunch. Third gear is way too high for this corner. Kind of like the stability. I think we can make this work. And I'm sure he will pit much sooner than I will, too. Yeah, this thing's a little too spin happy in second gear. 5.4, we're losing. R390, you're a little too good at this track. I expected this to be a complete blowout. Of course, this is the R390 we're talking about, which is unreasonably good in this game. Well, that was our best lap, not by much. But... oh, we actually did close in slightly. Our little Astra is not going anywhere, R390, so you can just deal with it. We're not going anywhere. We're not going anywhere. He's still trying to have that 5 second lead. We're not having it though. We still have some pretty vigorous acceleration in third gear even. I don't like how we hit that wall. That kind of messes up. Yo, I don't know if we can win this or not. I really don't know. Who would ever think that I'd have this much trouble on this track? The R390 actually is not really failing, man. That's just not failing. Of course, it doesn't usually fail much. I got a good exiting speed there. .2 seconds, we're trying. Oh, I see him. is this my imagination, or is he getting a little... Oh, he is getting a little closer. He is getting a little closer. Could the mighty R390 be slacking a little bit? Ooh. Ooh, I'm getting a little excited now. Janelle Monday. Whatever that means. Oh yeah, come here, baby. $2.7 million. That up. It's all right though. Wow, that was a pretty good lap. No wonder I caught him a little bit. You better be getting scared, R390, despite your superior power and handling capabilities. My little Astra is coming for you. Hit that wall. Be a good boy and hit that wall. And then pull away from me dramatically. It's alright. It's alright. We got this. Now getting around him, man, that's gonna be the real fun thing to try. Not taking a good driving line through here. Oops, didn't mean to hit you there, buddy. So sorry. We're really not buddies, though. Dang it. Yeah, getting around him, man. This track's so hard to pass anybody in. It's not like I can pass him on a straightaway or anything, because he has so much more power. So I'll somehow have to overtake him on a corner, which is not easy to do. So let's see, think about how long I'm gonna pit. Could I go 26, 78 divided by 3 is 26. If I could go that far, I don't know. Golly, look how far behind everybody else is. And it's just me and R390. Way up here in our own little world. I didn't mean to do that, but it happened. I'm sorry? Kinda. Is he pitting? No, he's not pitting. I really didn't mean for that to happen. It happened, though. And I have the lead! That was pretty dirty. I didn't mean for that to happen that way. Oh, well. I was wondering how I was going to get around him, and I guess that was the only way, wasn't it? We just couldn't do it clean. Not on this track. Not Sky. Nope. Well, Astra, golly, come on, man. Can't be having that. Well, we got the lead. It just took us 7 laps to do it. Which isn't as bad as I expected, considering how bad the first 3 laps were going. Light braking. Mugen sign. Pretty good exit on that corner. Oh yeah, we're really pulling away from him now. Almost a 6-second lead. Eh, we got this. We got this. I don't know if I can go 26 laps though without pitting. That may be kind of pushing it. Now, everybody else is kind of staying close. Then you have me and the R390. A little Opel Astra. She did that little area pretty good. Pretty good lap, I hope. Oh yeah, nice lap. I'm starting to get better here with this car and track and everything. Almost 10-second lead, wow. And he's still going on, which is good. Kind of glad he didn't pit right after I passed him. Six laps. I just don't see us going that far. So I may pit every 20 laps, which would mean the last group would be the last group of tires would only have 18 laps on them, but you know that's all right. Good lap, getting all these good laps. Which I like. And we're getting pretty close to overlapping somebody, which is pretty cool. The mighty R390, gosh, it was doing so well, man. It looked like I might not be able to win. I mean, it legitimately had me scared for a little while. Now look at us with our almost 14-second lead. Just 4 laps later, too. That's such a tight curve. Oh my golly, how did I miss that? Gaining on you. But we'll catch them on the next lap. So far, I don't guess anybody's really failing on this race. Nope, I'm already seeing them. Looks like a blue car, the GT40 probably. Seconds. I approve. Nice, comfortable little lead. Here's the GT40, which I probably will catch. Maybe not, because I'm sucking myself. Oh, really? What the heck was that even? I don't even know how that even happened. Oh my gosh, car! What the heck? Seriously, let's just lose 12 seconds, golly. Now that sucked. Still 9.5 seconds ahead. Golly, man, that was terrible. For some reason, I don't know, my car decided it wanted to spin. I wasn't really turning any differently than I had been. Maybe I did something and didn't notice it. I mean, was I in second gear or something? I don't feel like it was. Gosh. 12 freaking seconds. Look at that. 140 freaking six. I would really like to not give the lead back to the R39. That would be probably a good thing. Freaking GT40 and blame it all on me. Didn't take that very good. Oh my heavens. Learn a valuable lesson. Don't drive like a nut. Man, he pits after 13 laps. Kind of saw it coming. At least we got around this GT40 easy this time. Golly, man. So now to catch these three knuckleheads. The FTO actually is not last. Yeah, I think in this race you could see all of the LM cars. Like the Impreza or the S2000. I did briefly test this, I didn't really do any laps. Only like a few days ago, just to see what kind of cars I'd be versing. So, Okay. Maybe we can get around this Jaguar easily. If we're gonna get a 133 or not, looks like 134 might be our best lap. The FDO actually doing pretty good. Okay, car, golly man, you ghosted in this car and it was wild. Gonna use the FTO for this. Undoubtedly, I'd be doing much better, you know, because it has a lot more power, and is probably easier to control, being all-wheel drive. So, only 15 laps, and we've already spun out once. Oh, can I get around you? Yes. Please don't hit me in the booty, please. I don't like to be hit in the butt. That wasn't that good of a lap. Well, we did almost spin out once. So, third place is this Panos, kind of as I expected. The FTO actually is doing pretty good, though. Quite well. Get around you. Maybe. Yeah, Panels, hit every single wall. Do like I did in Tokyo. Well, everybody's lapped. And I imagine, as it tries to overlap everybody, the R390 will be inhibited. Because he hadn't had to try to pass anybody this whole race. But he will now. This will be his first time interacting with anybody besides me. Oh, that hairpin there is so sharp. Getting close to lap 20. Tires still aren't looking that bad. Proud to say though, with that Supra, I didn't spin out one time. That was one endurance race that I did not spin out once in. Of course, Tokyo is not, it's a pretty easy track to not spin in. But heck, 100 laps, so me driving, no spins. I think it doesn't matter what track that is. Me driving, you know. This race seems to be passing by real quickly. Yeah, 13 laps was 1/6 of the way, so. Yeah, was guessing it'd probably take around 2 hours, but it might not take that long. We'll see where I am on lap 26. We'll have a better idea of just how long this is really going to take. Yeah, I think the R390 is just now catching the GT40. Oh, no, I think it passed it, because the way I see it flying, getting ahead on the map. So the GT40 didn't hold it up very much. Matter of fact, the R390 caught up to me slightly, so I know that it didn't hold it down very much. Well, I felt like that was a pretty good lap until that little section. Just had to ruin it. Had to miss it. I think we can go 26 laps. I really do. I mean, our tires still have some life in them. Those laps after lap 20 probably are going to be pretty rough, but we got enough of a lead. I regret doing this. Nobody else has pitted except for the R390. We're actually getting the same lap times on this track as we got on Tokyo. Pretty much the exact same lap time. Except I don't know if we'll get a 133 here. I'm sure it's possible with this car. Certain as possible. Good exit on that. Yeah, I don't think we need to pit right now. So the R390 is interacting with the masses now, but he's not really getting slowed down very much. We're a little over a 4, so if you did 31 times 4, though, that would be, or 20 times, yeah, 32 times 4. It'd be 128. But it shouldn't quite take that long. We're well over a quarter of the way. Another good lap. We didn't need to pit yet. We're still getting pretty good laps. Decent lap times. That wasn't very far off my best lap. car. No. I do not permit that. Finally got 40 seconds. So is the R390. Yeah, it definitely is on the Esperante now. Taking down the Esperante. Probably won't hold it up very long. Mess ups on that lap. Nothing terrible, but you know. Wondering if going all the way lap 26 is a good idea on these tires. We're still doing all right. We'll see how this lap goes if I don't have any screw-ups. Still pulling away. Hot stuff. Golly, yeah, it did not take him long at all to get by everybody else. I mean, they were little more than a nuisance, than a mild nuisance. It wasted no time blasting through them. Oh yeah, we're still getting some good laps. Right now, tires aren't really red yet, they're just kind of dark orange. So I think 26 is definitely a possibility. Well, we know it's going to be possible because we're doing it anyway, but definitely a possibility. We just don't know how good of a possibility it is. We don't know how well it's going to bode for us. Second late though. Almost 46. Can't complain. How many laps? He went 13 laps, so he's going to pit the same time I do, the same lap. I'm just going twice as far as he is. You know, he actually, golly, that really makes the Arthur 90 relatively tough to beat on this, because it's like it's, it's dividing its pit stops evenly amongst the race to get the best use out of its tires. Well, that does make it pretty tough opposition. If you weren't a big racing nerd like I am, you might have some trouble on this. Or if you were using even a slower car than this. We're still getting some pretty decent lap times. So it looks like it's going to take well more than 2 hours. Having the first indication of that. Because, not 1 second here. There's the FTO. Did the FTO seriously get passed by the GT40? It was way in front of the GT40. Yeah, because 40 minutes would be 1/3. Or I mean, 40 times 3 is 120, but it's going to be probably 42 minutes for or more after we finish lap 26. Well, FTO, here you are in last. I wonder if it pitted. I didn't even pay attention. If it did pit, I didn't ever notice it. Maybe it needs to pit. Maybe that's the problem. Well, of course, you're faster than them, so you're going to be in my way. Wonderful. I shouldn't have expected any less. Oh, God. Oh, I did not mean to do that. Gosh. I'm just being so mean on this train. It was an accident, I promise. Golly, you are sucking. Get out of my way. Oh my gosh, look at this. Pass it now. We've let it slow us down enough. Okay, pass it. Gosh, seriously, what kind of crap is this? Because we messed up that, now it's going to be in our way more. Great. Golly, that lap was terrible. Yeah, so around 42 minutes for a third of this. So, probably 2 hours and 6 minutes for this whole race. Which will be our second longest endurance race. It's gonna suck so bad. When I pit, I'm gonna have to get back around these idiots. I think it's probably gaining on me a little bit. Which, you know, I wouldn't be surprised after those bad laps. Golly, 140. Whew. I think more of that could be attributed to them being in my way, though, than me having bad tires. I have a feeling if this were not a pit lap, I probably would actually have a better time on it. This pit stop looks really neat. It's pretty neat. There they go. Joy. Oh, well, thank you for downshifting us a second. That's so sweet. Well, we were maintaining our 46 second lead. Oh, he's going to pit too, though, I think. It's actually a pretty interesting endurance race. I'm glad I picked this underpowered Aster. So judging by how this race has gone so far, since we're a third of the way, I'm going to guess that these dingbats will be 6 laps behind by the end. Maybe just 5 if I have a, you know. if the latter two-thirds of this race are worse than the first third. Hopefully they'll be better. FTO, you were doing really good. Golly, what's happened to you? It must have messed up or something. I mean, because it's not getting around as GT40. Although it's trying to. Get out of my way. Can't believe I actually passed y'all as quickly as I did. But we had to do that, so yay. How freaking delightful. I really don't want to mess with y'all. Get back there. There we go. That should get rid of them. This certainly ain't gonna be a best lap. Oh my gosh. What is going on here? We're not doing very well. It actually caught me a little bit, which is not surprising at all. Caught me quite a bit. Was 46 seconds. Yeah, he'll probably catch me a little bit between now and lap 32, I'd say. It's all right then. Here's the Jaguar. The Jaguar's just kind of been here. Yeah. It's not really been much of a player. It's just in fourth place minding its own business. Can I get right into you easily? Sure wasn't expecting it. The Jaguar continues to be a non-factor. I don't even know who all has pitted on this race. I know the R390i have, but I don't remember ever seeing any of the other ones pit. Surely they have by now. Think you're gaining on me, don't you? Squeal. You know, our times would be a lot better if we wouldn't do that. Goodness gracious. Catching up to this person, the Pinoz. Right. I need to look that car up because I'm kind of interested. Is that a car that's made in Mexico or Central or South America? Or is it North American? It says American, but I'm supposing that could include, you know, South and Central America as well. The name is kind of, you know, something you expect of from that. And it is pitting. So I know you pitted Esperanto after, what, 28 laps? How come I can't take the curb right anymore? What's going on? Only 62 miles in this car. This race won't even be long enough to make our oil light come on, will it? There we go, we're pulling away from the R390 a little bit. Oh my gosh, let's not do that. Not. So if you know much, if you know more than I do about the Esperanto, which I'm sure you do, feel free to leave it in the comments. Let me know more about it. I don't know, the information this game might actually tell you a little bit. I haven't even tried it. It's something that I haven't really been utilizing much. I did show it off at the beginning of the project, but that's about all we've done. Not quite reaching that 50 seconds yet. I'm telling you what, it's a close race for a long endurance race like this. Halfway will be 39 laps. Got a really good exit speed there. Still not a best lap, I'm sure. No. Not even close. What was it? Good lad. At least we're all by ourselves for a little while. The bright sun. This is a fun track. Oh wow, almost 52 seconds. So it will be pitting on 39. Gosh. This was a good lap until that. Had to miss it. No swerving. that could have been a really good lap if I hadn't messed up that, I did that curve really well. If I hadn't messed up that end there. Track, I'd say. Right by the seaside. Would have been nice to have a good exiting speed without hitting wall there. But can't always get what we want. This was a good lap. I don't know about best, but it was best. Wow. Yeah, I tried too hard there and I messed up. Like I could get a 133, but oh man, it would take near perfection. Like if I'd taken that curve there the way I did on this lap, if I did that way on the last lap, I would have had a 133. I'm sure of it. Wow. Wow. XJ220 is pit. Is that his first pit stop? So is the XJ220 last now? I have no idea. So sharp. This tunnel is really nice too. Hey, I did that little section better. 102? Oh yeah, you're going down, huh? Bad boy, you're going down. You and your far superior car. Oh good, you're pitting. Is that his first pit stop? Oh, I could have sworn he pitted one other time. I don't even know, I hadn't been paying attention. There's so many curves and stuff in this track. I'm just good to pay attention to myself and make sure I don't into a wall. So So our next pit stop will be 52. And that will be our last pit stop. Oh, you're in my way. Jaguar. Miles an hour there. Probably not a good idea. Replay save complete. See, it did so much earlier on this track. I don't even know why. One track, one race actually went up to 85 minutes before it said that. What's going on? Does that have to do with the amount of frames or something? The amount of the complexity of the track? Take more space up or something? Right at an hour. And we've gone 76 miles in an hour. So that means an average of 76 miles an hour. Which is actually faster than I would have thought with the straight. Oh my heavens. That chicane very well there. Imagine we will overlap that R390 at least once. Probably not gonna happen twice though. Then again, I didn't expect to overlap the Super and the NSX four times in the last race, so who knows. So this is the halfway point. I'm thinking 2 hours and 6 minutes. Well, FTO, you are back in what places? Fourth? Beating the Jaguar and the Jaguar and the GT40. So, wow. Doing better than I thought. Well, overlapped you nice and easy. Kind of how I like it. Little conflict. I'm not a person that likes a lot of conflict anyway. Oh wow, I actually did that curve very well. Oh yeah, 133. We did manage to do it. Goal accomplished. It's the only goal I had for this race. I'm just kidding. Yeah, that was the halfway point. Yeah, it looks like 2 hours and 6 minutes. Looks like that's gonna be it. This Astra does not even fit in. It's funny. Who cares about fitting in, though? We'll make it fit in. That right little Astra. You deserved a chance, didn't you, baby doll? Y'all, I cannot believe, even with me passing the FTO, that was the fastest lap. Even with the interaction. R390, catching you, R390, catching you. He's moving now. Swerved a lot in this one third of the race, the second third. Well, he must have come out of the pit ahead of this, probably the Esperanto. Yeah, it is. Esperante. So everybody's been overlapped twice by this R390. And three times by me. You're in my way. I don't want to hit you, but you make it so hard. Gosh. Man, I just have to hit you, don't I? Have to hit you. Look at you. You think you're all something. Swerving all over the way in front of me. Goodbyes. Oh, crying out loud. Don't even know how to drive. Gosh. Oh, this Astra. Not far from this GT90 or R390. It's GT90. Completely different car, Sky. Completely different car. Speaking of the GT90, golly, it. The only Gran Turismo it's even in is the Gran Turismo 2. And I think it actually is a legit car. So it's kind of surprising that it's not more of. Turn, oh my heaven, and then you want to oversteer. After not turning, you want to oversteer. Yeah, makes a lot of sense, Astra. Makes a lot of sense. We're catching you, baby. Catching you. My little main machine.
Nandy.
So he's doing pretty good. He ain't hitting many of the walls at all. Are you actually gonna let me buy you? Yes, you are. Gee, you're sweet. He just pitted too. I'm actually really surprised I pulled that off. I hadn't fully yet. Gosh. Oh my gosh, he's so much faster. Okay, let's see if we can stay in front of him. If I don't get far enough ahead of him before this straightaway up here, then, he will have us for lunch. Yeah. Yeah. Definitely give us some momentum to get away from that very, very bloodthirsty Arthur 90. So not too long till we pit last time. Did fairly well on that. Thought I was gonna not do fairly well. Oh great, here comes the R3 or the GT40, whatever you call it. Who is way in last. Golly, I caught you that quickly. What have you been doing, GT40? What have you been doing? Don't answer that. I remember that one lap. Which one was it that I kept hitting and kept pushing? Was it the FTO or was it the GT40? I just could not get around it, man. Oh, he's ticking me off. Probably was both of them. That was a really good exit on that. Old GT40, you're about to get eaten. How many times is he down? Four times? I think I predicted six for the whole race, didn't I? The FDO's way ahead of him. Thank you. bad lap for so late. No, pretty good lap action. Not a bad lap at all. When I pit this time, the GT R390 will keep going. I'd like to get far enough ahead where they wouldn't pass me. That'd be nice. That'd be less I'd have to worry about. Although he will pit on the next lap, the lap down. Whoa, too late. That's that up, isn't it? It's still not a horrible lap. Third, and just like in Laguna Seca, I'm in third and fourth gear nearly this whole race. Occasionally fifth gear on that high speed section after the tunnel. Hi, FTO. Are you going to mess me up more? Probably. Nice fresh tires. Not really a good place to draft. Oh my gosh. I could have got around it there. Well, don't worry, I did there. Question is, can I get far enough ahead where I don't have to worry about messing with it after I get out of the pit? Somehow I doubt it because I only have three laps and my tires are not in the best condition. It wasn't a bad lap, huh? Would have been much better, you know, except for the end there. Then I got this guy. Ah, well. We're at that point, we're going to be constantly interacting with people. I'm antisocial, though. I don't want to be interacting. Crap, I'm at it. What am I doing? That is not good. Okay, we're going to pass you, but since you have so much more power than me, I'm sure. Or maybe not. Maybe you're not going to pass me. That works too. Oh, wow. I made that work somehow. That wall. Golly, we really pulled away from that Jaguar though. It's probably, what, 6 seconds behind already? It's pretty amazing. The FTO and the GT40 seem to be gaining on it. Or that may be that's probably the R390 that's behind me. Bet you it is. We don't want to be in the second gear. Not a bad lap, not a bad lap, especially for so late. Oh wow, we've really gotten away from those three cars there. The Jaguar, the GT40, and the FTO. Or no, the GT40, the Jaguar, I don't know. R39? I want to say that it's probably right behind me there. Either way, it's not really right behind me. I don't know. I still think if I were to pit now, they would probably catch me. Sliding little car, are you? Sliding little car. Had a good cornering on that. Not really getting any bad laps. Especially considering these tires, you know. And 135 ain't bad. It's only 2 seconds worse than my best lap. Okay. I'm glad on this second, third of the race we haven't had any spin outs. That's definitely a plus. Did that corner really well. Oh, Astra. Oh, our last pit stop. Looks like we may get it in under 2 hours and five, or under 2 hours and 6 minutes now. And none of them are gonna catch us. And that's probably the R390 that's right behind me there. If I had to guess. Yep, it is. I can tell. Don't look back. The monster's near. He's gonna pit on this lab, though. Don't expect him to be catching me much. Seems like this race has gone by so much faster than Tokyo. I don't know, this track's just more fun to me. As evil as it is. Just so twisty and sharp, and I guess I like sharp things in there. Self-consciously, maybe I do. Turn. Oh my gosh, Carl, can't be having that. Can't be having it. I know you like to spin, but no. There he goes. As I suspected. Man, that Formula GT thing. That's what we're doing next, y'all. Are y'all ready for it? Am I ready for it? Good Lord. Don't know. Tire's still cold. Okay, let's just hit that. I'm a total idiot. Car so slick, man. Full spin. Oh my heavens, really? We're gonna try to spin the air car? Love to spin even more than I expected. Nah, I can't say I'm surprised. Also can't say I'm surprised I'm messing up this lap. Because I'm not. So I did that section right. Take what you can get, I guess. She didn't hit that wall. What do you know? Wasn't a bad lap except for messing up that one little section. Before that high speed section. And now we're coming up to some more traffic. A lot of traffic. Golly, and I'm gaining on him real fast, too. Kind of scary. Well, it has to happen eventually. Why am I messing up that curve so much now? This whole race we hadn't messed up that corner. Now I'm messing up all the time. What the heck? Alright, here you come. Here I come into a wall. Remarkable. Remarkably sucky. This was a really good lap until that. Well, I had a really good exit there. Got by you easier than I expected. Of course, you're a lot faster than I am, so... Okay. No worries. No worries. I guess this race seems to have gone so much faster. It will be shorter anyway, but I mean, it seems to have gone so much faster. Probably because the R390 has been, you know, much more of a opponent than any of the opposition in the last few races. Gosh, why am I doing so bad now? I can only do good for so long. Hey now. That last race, though, golly, on Tokyo, I freaking was a boss on the last 20 laps of that race. I was a boss. Unbelievable. I mean, I amazed even myself. That's hard to do, you know. All right, probably not gonna happen on this race. Here comes the last 20 laps, and so far things aren't too promising, but you know, it's all right. We got victory, as long as nothing really drastic happens. I mean, I'd have to really suck super bad in order for the R39 to catch me. Gosh. I'm trying for a good lap. Golly, that Esperanto's already so far behind. Hard to believe it's actually getting third. Shows you how bad these other ones are. Yeah, I'm a boss at that corner. Oh, yeah. Said, not really. Alright, that was a pretty decent lap, I thought. Oh, it was. Wow, that was the best lap. I really was not expecting that one. I mean, I was expecting a 134, you know, but the best lap... It shows you how much I've been slagging this whole race. Not really slagging, but just not getting the best out of this car. Okay, what was that? I don't know. I don't want to know. I don't want to know. Here's GT40. Got by easy that time, didn't I? Just had to hit that wall. Poor baby. Just like I had to hit that wall. Jeez. That's what I get for mocking the GT40. How dare I mock a GT40? That's a classic. Wow, he is that far back there already. That's pretty sad. Eighteen more laps, y'all. Or actually 19, because you gotta count this one. Car, what the heck? Thought we were friends. You gonna try and do that to me? What the heck? Can't be having. I'm getting really good at that corner. Seven or 18 more laps. We're getting there. Slowly but steadily. I've long since run out of things to say. Esperante pitting in. Dang it. If only that wall weren't there. Dang. If that wall weren't there, everybody'd be doing a lot better. And not just me. What the heck? Completely, our car turns in the opposite direction. Because reasons, you know. Well, that wasn't a good lap at all. Hi, Jaguar. I have no idea how far we are behind. Is this maybe your fifth time being overlapped? I really have no idea. All I know is it's been too many times. Here's the FTO, which I guess is beating the Jaguar. Assuming they're on the same lap. Which I think they probably are. Here, FTO. just get by you. Thank you. Appreciate it. Our car didn't completely turn in the opposite direction like it did on the last lap. That was annoying. It happened. And hey, 134. Lotus and Bridgestone signs. You know, I haven't seen Alfa Romeo be advertised very many times. That's not fair. I mean, yeah, there is only one Alfa Romeo in this game, but still. Alfa Romeo is a really nice automaker. I mean, I don't know. I've never driven one. I honestly don't know much about them, but I mean, they look nice. Wow, another good lap. What's going on here? These laps have all been pretty good except for 61. Yeah, I forgot to shift into fifth until too late. Well, you know. What do you expect from me at this point? I mean, you know. Oh my gosh, I completely lose my mind through this section. Lose my rhythm. But I fixed it. Okay, I do not allow you to do that, car. Behave. Behave. Twenty more minutes, something like that. I just think it's shorter than that Tuscan race now, or whatever one it was. No, it was the Dream Car Championship, wasn't it? Where they made us do 20 laps around this freaking track. Hi there, person who's in front of me. Who are you? Oh, it's the Esperante. The freaking Esperante. Hi there, Esperante. How you doing? If you don't mind, I'm just going to kind of go around here. I'm sure you don't mind. No, you don't. I'm also going to hit this wall and let you pass me back. I'm sure you really don't mind that. Well, we are 5/6 of the way through this race now. Woo! I wasn't paying attention. Wow, late braking. Esperanto's probably wondering what in the heck's wrong with him. Oh my gosh, oh my. Whoa. Car, you've been doing really good and now you're sucking. What's going on with you? Yes, I'm blaming it all on the car. Of course I am. It would never be my fault. Never. I love by all these corners it says take first gear, and yet here I'm taking them at third. Oh gosh, I don't ever do things right. It makes me wonder how much better or worse would I do if I had an automatic. Makes me wonder. I think I would probably do worse. Yeah, good exiting speed on that corner. Still got some sense left in us. It's only lap 67, we're better. Still got a ways to go. That R39 is. Wonder where he is. And wow, that was a surprisingly good lap. That wall. Ouch. So I probably have the worst commentary in the history of all LPers. Well, except for the ones that just F-word this and F-word that. I mean, that's a little much. But it might be one of those, maybe. What the heck am I doing? Gosh. Word. this was a bad lap. I don't even know where I was. Maybe it wasn't a bad lap. It seemed like it was. Way to go, stopwatch, for disagreeing with me. But now here's 69, so this is bound to be a doozy here. Who is this wonderful? Oh, it's the GT40. Oh, hi. Still haven't forgot what you did to me on whatever lap that freaking was. I don't know. Lap 8 or 9 or something. Okay, drafted him and then, they're all faster than I am. Even this GT40 here. That was the fastest we've gone. Well, that was a nice clean pass. Somehow. This might actually be a decent lap. Okay, please. It was a pretty good lap. Hooray. And now we are into the 70s. Yes. 14 more minutes. If my estimation was correct. Astra, see what you got this last eight and a half laps. Where is it, R390? I know I'm not going to overlap him twice, but taking that curve like a pro. XJ220 speeding. Good, that's one less person that I have to worry about messing with me. If I didn't swerve on that last corner, that would have been a 134. Oh well. I'm way too critical. So here's the FTO. And I'm guessing the next one's probably the R390. I don't know. Obviously. Okay, dang, I could have passed him there. Let's go for it. This ain't gonna be clean at all, but you know what, I don't care. Hit that wall, FTO. Hit that wall. Oh man, do not goose it in this thing. Do not. Not on this track. Goosing this thing at low speeds is a recipe for disaster. Wow, look at how good that lap was. Oh yeah, I'm good. Sitting there. So good. Oh, gosh. Oh, the last leg, y'all. We're almost there. This LP. Well, we still have the Formula GT. And then after that, the GT World's going to be nothing, you know, after doing those... After doing that, in an arcade mode, you know. It'll go by pretty quickly in comparison. Listening to my music, not saying anything. Totally what an LP'er should do, you know, just not saying anything. Also trying to concentrate. So I can collapse. Alright, 6 more laps. We can do this. 10 more minutes, we should be done. Who is this car in front of me? I was trying to look ahead and see if I can tell who that car in front of me is, but I have a feeling it's the R390. I really do. I have done better on the last 2/3 of this race, so it's possible that I could get close to overlapping him. But I'm kidding myself if I think that I'm actually going to overlap him twice. If I had some better laps like I was having, I might get pretty close. I don't think 135s are going to cut it, though. If I can get some more 134s. I don't know. This is getting interesting. Let's see if I can catch him. Then again, watch it not even be the R390. May not be. Probably isn't. It could be the Pinales, because it's also been a little while since seeing it. Car swerving, dang you. Had to make things difficult on me. Still not close enough to see that it was. I don't know, judging from how slow that I'm catching it, it might be that R390. If so, how far you've sunk R390? To be overlapped twice by an Astra. Another 134, despite how bad that lap was. Oh, I saw a glimpse. Ooh. Can't tell, though. It could still be the Esperante. Guess I'll be seeing soon. Oh, it is him! Oh, wow, we gotta do this. Oh, these last four laps just got interesting. Oh, I want to take you down. Take you down. Oh, yeah. Focus on that exit speed. No way, I can't believe him. I don't know. I knew that he was... Yeah, it's him. Oh, it's him. Yeah, I knew that I was having a hard time catching up to him. I was gaining on him, but not that quickly, so... Because if it's Esperante, I would be eating it up. I'm surprised because I didn't fully overlap him to like 42 or something. I don't remember exactly when it was, but it was way past the halfway point. On Astra, three more laps. Golly, we're gaining on everybody else too. I was thinking I wasn't going to overlap anybody else except for this person, but this happens to be the Arthur 90s. And we're gaining on this other person real quickly. Oh, come on, that car. Slowly closing the gap. Late braking is not going to help there. Go, we're gaining on him. Golly, this is gonna be hard to overlap him. This GT40 is probably gonna slow him down though. Wouldn't it be something if I overlapped the GT40 before overlapping the Arthur? I mean, golly, and I was so close to the Arthur 90. The GT40 was way up there. Yep, he's getting by that GT40 very quickly. The GT40 is gonna slow me down. Thank you, GT40. Thank you. I could have probably got around him too, but no. And now I did. Oh yeah, we got you. GT40, golly, that GT40 is putting up a fight. I was like, y'all overlapped me too many times. GT40, quit that. Be a good sport. Alright. We can totally do this. Golly, that GT40 so much faster. Not a GT40, but this thing. I keep calling it a GT40. It's not a GT40. Okay, you're in my way. Shoot a monkey. My tires are bad, his tires are bad. God, look how bad that lap was. Oh my heavens. I still think I can lap him though, despite screwing up the end of that lap. I think I'm just trying too hard now. This this probably was the best place to lap him, but really good exit speed there. Pass him. Okay, that didn't work in my favor. Well, dang it. Yeah, that was the B on the first few laps of this race. I just could not get around his butt, you know. And no different now. Oh well, we could have done it, but we didn't. Anyways, we finished. And pretty much about two laps ahead of that R3290, whatever it is. And yeah, that's about where I thought everybody was. The GT40 is a whopping 7 laps behind, wow. I figure the FTO and XJ220 and Esperanto are probably all 6. Alrighty, they all finished. So this Bronto was only 5 laps behind, but yeah, still 2 hours and 5 minutes, 21 seconds. Yeah, we actually did a lot better on the latter 2/3 of that race, you know, which actually made it be quite a bit less than 2 hours, 6 minutes. But yeah, that was a very fun race. I mean, it really was. I enjoyed it with this Astra. You know, it wasn't overly easy, you know. R390 provided quite a challenge. But as it stood, we pretty much about overlapped it by 2 laps. I mean, we were right behind it at the finish line. And I just couldn't get past it. It was so much faster. Oh, Aster. Took some getting used to, man. I lay there for a while. The first few laps, I was like, oh man, I did not pick a good choice for this race. Is that R390, heaven's sake. Making a stupid choice, stupid move like that. I love how this track, it actually parallels and you actually see the other side in the replay. GT40 hitting all the walls. Yeah, that was pretty fun. Its tires are much more worn than mine were. FTO. Oh yeah, the FTO was making more frequent pit stops. The Jaguar was going a while too. So yeah, the GT40 got last, the Jaguar got 5th. And the Esperanto, it was just clearly the better car. Because it had the same tires but still beat them. That was fun. That was a very fun race. I've said a million times already. What'd I get? Another FTO. And a silver. How many colors is the FTO? Oh, simulation mode endurance complete. Oh, what's that? Oh, I think it's one that I've already gotten, actually. It's just a different color. So yeah, we did all these. So well, car wash. Good old Astra. served us well. Opal Service. I never did win the Calibra in this game. The Calibra is in this game, though. I think we did see it in the German touring car. There are a lot of cars that I didn't win. And if I hadn't spent so many hours already on this project, I would probably go through and try to win them all. But golly, so long. So yeah, do I like this dark blue more or that green? These are exact same. I think I like the green better, simply. We'll sell the blue one, I guess. I do kind of like it. Eh, heck, we'll keep it. I ain't gonna sell this FTO, though. Say I won like a blue one of those, a white one, a black one. I've won so many of those. Gosh. I think it comes in green. The one I have I still have the black one. Yeah, I like this. This car is sharp and black. But, yeah. So what is our percent looking like? 74.4. Golly, those endurance races really don't count for very much. 12,180 miles. We all think this is a good stopping point, so then we'll thank you all very much for watching. This has been Sky Hurricane. Hope you have a super awesome, blessed day. Join us next time for the Formula GT Championship. Oh, it's going to be a long one. Hope to see you there. Stay awesome.